And we know Israel sees Hamas as a security threat. Israel sees Iran as an existential threat. And while Israel is on the boil, there's a churn in Iran. An election is on, and as we speak, the Islamic Republic is electing its next president. So who is running for office in Iran? Who is likely to win, and what's at stake? What does this election mean for those watching us from India? Tonight we'll discuss all of this. Let's start with a quick primer. Iran is a country of 648 million square kilometers, surrounded by Pakistan, Afghanistan, Turkmenistan, Azerbaijan, Armenia, Turkey, Iraq, and Kuwait. Iran has a population of nearly 85 million. 60 million of them are eligible to vote. 90% of Iran's population practices Shia Islam. It also happens to be the country's official religion. Let's look at Iran's political system. At the apex is the supreme leader. Below him, the country's president. Iran also has an elected legislature and a judiciary. Elections in Iran are controlled by a council of guardians, both parliamentary and presidential elections. Now, this council of guardians has 12 members. Six of its members are from the clergy, and they're chosen by the country's supreme leader, the Ayatollah. The council decides who can run for president. So who is running this time? Reports say nearly 600 people registered to be the president of Iran, 600 people. The council rejected most of them. 40 were shortlisted. 7 candidates finally got the go-ahead. 3 of them pulled out of the race, which leaves us with 4 presidential candidates. Who are these? Mohsen Raisi. He is the secretary of Iran's Expediency Discernment Council. Yes, there is such a thing. Syed Ibrahim Raisi, the chief justice of Iran. Amir Hussein Ghazi Zadeh Hashemi, the first vice speaker of the parliament, and Abdul Nasser Hemati, former governor of the Central Bank of Islamic Republic of Iran. All of them are close to the supreme leader, Ayatollah Khamenei. And one of them is a clear favorite, Ibrahim Raisi. Who is this man? He's 60 years old. He's tipped to be Iran's next Ayatollah. Right now, he's tipped to be the next president. He's currently the chief of judiciary. He was appointed to this position in 2019. In 2017, he contested the presidential election against Rouhani. He was the front runner. In 1988, when Ayatollah Khomeini, the previous Ayatollah, issued a fatwa and called for the death of dissidents, Raisi was made what is called the death commissioner. What did he do as death commissioner? He interrogated political prisoners. And he's said to have sentenced to death all those who fail to show loyalty to the clerical regime. How many people are we talking about? At least 30,000 people. After being appointed the judiciary chief, Raisi is said to have overseen the torture and murder of thousands of activists who were arrested during the anti-regime uprising in November 2019. Raisi is a hardliner. He owes his career to patronage of Iran's Ayatollahs. In the run-up to this election, he promised a strong Iran. He pledged to focus on the country's economy. So what do the people of Iran think about all of this? Let's look at what's happening on the ground. Polling booths have been open since 7 a.m. local time, which is 2:30 GMT and 8 a.m. IST. Voting is expected to go on till midnight local time, 19:30 GMT, 1 a.m. IST. Voting can be extended for up to 2 hours if required. A state-run polling agency predicts a turnout of lower than 40%. We don't have the latest figures yet, but this was the prediction before the election. And compare this to 2017. We saw a 70% voter turnout. That shows how interested and engaged the people are with this electoral process. What about the results? They should be out by the end of Saturday, meaning Iran will get its next president in less than 24 hours by now. From now. Currently in office is Hassan Rouhani. He's 72 and he has exhausted both his terms. What's in store for his successor? Well, not exactly a bed of flowers. The price of milk in Iran, for instance, has risen 90%. The cost of imported goods like phones and electronics has skyrocketed. The value of the rial has hit rock bottom. Today, with $1, you can buy more than 42,000 rials. Iran's economy is at its worst since the revolution. Also at the lowest point are Iran's foreign relations. This has impacted the country's oil exports. In 2016, Tehran used to export 2.8 million barrels per day. Then came the American sanctions. Energy monitoring firms say Iranian oil exports have dropped to 600,000 barrels per day. There are also protests at home and expectations from countries abroad. There's uncertainty around the 2015 nuclear deal. Iran is also currently only the second country in the world on the FATF blacklist for terror financing. North Korea is the first one. So the world will be watching how the new president finds a way to rebuild the country's economy in the face of international sanctions and scrutiny. So how much can Iran's next president really change? Well, to be fair, an Iranian president does not have a lot of power. While he still calls the shots on the country's economy and perhaps some domestic affairs, everything outside it is under the Ayatollah's jurisdiction. But we say a change of guard always marks a new beginning, so we'll have to wait and see where Iran goes from here. Next question. What will India be looking for in the next regime? I would say stable relations. India and Iran are old allies. They shared a border until 1947. 74 years on, Iran remains one of India's major trade partners. Between 2012 and 2020, India's exports to Iran grew by more than 45%. While India has suspended oil imports from Iran, the two countries continue to cooperate in several other sectors. India is developing the first phase of the Chabahar port. Recent reports say Iran also wants to rope in India for a gas project, perhaps at a later stage. When the Wuhan virus pandemic began, India delivered PPE kits and PCR machines to Iran. In June 2020, India also supplied pesticides to Iran to help it fight desert locusts. The point we're making is simple. New Delhi has a long-standing relationship with Tehran and will be hoping that this partnership only grows with the new regime. We're watching this election and we'll ask you to watch this space for updates. WeOn is now available in your country. Download the app now and get all the news on the move.